The research that I've been involved with for several years involves looking at factors contributing to compassion fatigue and burnout in geriatric care managers. Burnout is the result of a cumulative process of gradually wearing down of our reserves with little recharging of our energies. So basically what that's telling us is that it doesn't happen overnight. It happens after a period of time where individuals have been in a high-stress work situation where they have not had many opportunities to recharge as a result of the stress that they're experiencing. On the other hand, compassion fatigue is really not a product of a long process. It can be the product of one critical, very traumatic incident or one encounter with a client whose life situation was very traumatic and the care manager was impacted by the trauma that the client was experiencing. The sample that I worked with early on in the project involved geriatric care managers, and I was coordinating contacting with them through the Illinois Department on Aging. When I asked the geriatric care managers what specific client life situations were the most difficult for them, several were identified, but three primarily seemed to rise to the top and were mentioned most frequently. The first one they indicated were clients that were in an abusive life situation. And there's a lot of different types of abuse and neglect that can occur. The second one that was difficult for them were clients that were living in extreme poverty situations. And these are situations where the clients are either going without or have very diminished capacity to obtain what we consider to be basic life needs. The third one that they identified that was a difficult situation or challenging one for them were clients with dementia. And this is a very common type of situation of clients that they are providing assistance to. And again, when I asked them to elaborate a little bit more on why these situations were so challenging, they said with a dementia and particularly an Alzheimer's diagnosis, the individual situation is not going to improve. I think so many times, particularly in the human services discipline and gerontology is of course a reality with it as well. We are so predominantly focused on the clients and the client needs, and that's what we're training our students to do. And when I go out and do presentations, many times it's dealing with client life situations. And I think it's so important to maintain a focus too on the well-being of the professionals and having them have some sense of what is it that makes them vulnerable to burnout, and what are some of the ways that we can provide some suggestions for self-care for them. I've been doing a variety of different conference presentations that deal with compassion fatigue and burnout. I share with the individuals the results of the research that I conducted, and then I've added an additional component of ways that they can perhaps think about their lives and how they can integrate some self-care to help create, hopefully, some semblance of balance between the realities of the stress as well as the rewards of the work that they do and how they can integrate self-care practices.